Ruth chapter 1, verse 6. Then Naomi arose with her daughters-in-law to return from the country of Moab, for she had heard in the fields of Moab that the Lord had visited his people and given them food. Welcome to LifeWords Day by Day. When I was 7 years old, I ran away from home. I had hurled a rock at my big brother and it connected for maximum impact on the back of his leg. It inflicted all sorts of pain. He was picking on me in front of his friends, and so I retaliated back. But I knew that I had crossed a line. And so I packed a bag with underwear and a flashlight, and I got out of there as fast as I could. And I made it all the way down to the stop sign, two houses away, and I sat down, contemplating my next move as a man striking out on his own. Where would I go? What would I eat? Well, about that time, my father, returning home from somewhere, pulls up to that intersection of Bull Run and Kennesaw Mountain. He stopped the truck and asked me what I was doing. Well, I knew that my game was up. I reluctantly climbed into the cab of the truck, and it was the longest return back home of my life. I knew what awaited me at home, and that was all I could think about. Have you ever had to return down the long road home? That's a trail that all of us at one time or another have had to take. But all of us take that trip differently. Some of us walk that road with our excuses. Some of us try to return as if nothing ever happened in the first place. And then others of us try to push people out of our lives and just wallow in our being a victim. And some of you may be at the point where you need to return home now, to turn back to the Lord. I want you to know that if you do, there is plenty of bread in His home to satisfy your heart. His name is Jesus, and He is the bread of life. As you pray today, please remember Thomas Mobley and his family, our missionaries in Oklahoma. And also, remember the NACUSA LifeWord broadcast heard in Malawi and Tanzania.